Hello everyone, welcome to Merigoldi TV. Please, if today is your first time to watch or listen to my video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and also remember to press the bell sign. For those of you who don't already subscribe to this channel, thank you so much. To all my returning subscribers, thank you, thank you. I really appreciate each and every one of you. If you never see subscribe, what do you wait for? In this channel, they always bring latest updates, current news, ogbonge matter, as you just said, they happen. If you don't want me to miss any of these updates, just kindly press the subscribe button and the bell sign.
When you wake up in the morning, you see police brutality. When you walk out, you see police brutality. Inside your house, they will brutalize you. They will brutalize you. They think they are very smart. Well, we have been playing with them. We told you, we told the IGP before. Talk to the police. Restructure the police. If it's for them to increase the salary of the police, they should do it. They should go and increase the salary of the police. They should reform the police. They should build up their barrack. They should orient them properly. They should give them proper orientation. But they don't want to do it. They will not do it. The only thing that they can do, they are very happy with the brutalization. They are very happy with the brutalization. Because when police will keep brutalizing you, that is where they will start stealing your money. And when they store your money, and when you speak, they will send the police against you. Because they know the police are meant for brutality. For harmless citizens. For innocent citizens. For permanent citizens. For patriotic citizens. That is why they are very happy. You see? They are very happy. Now, it don't clear for their eye. It has cleared that even though they have been using juju or buju on us, it's no longer working. Nigeria has wake up. Tell them. Tell the minister that Nigeria has wake up. Tell the senators that Nigerians have waked up. They should get ready. Next, we are going. The next will be Buhari must go. And he must go. He must go. Let him go and send his soldier. Let him call Butai, the chief of staff, chief of army staff. Let them call them. Let them call them. They will do their worst. Let them bring the soldier. Why didn't he bring the soldier? If we are to be before, they will bring our soldier to change the people. They did it. Let them bring out the soldier. The world is watching. The world is watching. Everybody is watching. Let's see what they are going to do. If they are bigger than us, we will know. Who told them? They think because you have been given one position, because you are a minister, you think everybody is not slave. You are our servant. You are not our ruler, but you are our servant. You are not our leader, but you are our servant. A servant is meant to serve the people. A servant is not meant as a leader. It's a servant. You are either you are a civil servant or you are a public servant. That is the two thing. That is the two thing. How come a servant will not become the chief of everything? Will not become the servant of a servant. Who does that? Who does that? We will not become a servant of a servant. Who does that? They are our servants. They are meant to serve us. They are meant to serve us. They are not meant to be there to come and pray. Why will you oppress the citizen? The citizen have the rights. And I said, any protest, any Nigerian carries out, it is their fundamental human right. You don't take it for that. You see how police have been brutalizing us. We keep crying. Each and every day we cry. Our mother have cried their eyes. Our mother, we wake up, they can able to train the child up to the extent that the child is ready to pay back. At the end of the day, police will just shoot them. Boom. Just like that. And nobody's saying anything. Nobody is saying anything. I told you, I said, those who are supporting the PDP and the APC, you don't even know what you are doing. You don't know what you are doing. If you think you are supporting anyone according to his work towards you, you have failed. Because they will always respect their party. Have I not said this in several occasions? They will always respect their party. People were shouting, Wike, 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 because Wike came to the state election. They thought Wike was the man of the game. Was the man of the game. That is why Obaseki won. And I wonder, I say, who is Wike? Don't you add what Wike tweeted? Wike tweeted that there are in banned protests. And my question to Wike, which rights does Wike have to ban a protest? No government, no governor, no minister, no senator, no councillor. You don't have the right to ban a protest. Who told you? He said, Wike tweeted. He said, they have banned a protest. And I laughed. I said, look at this mocking. You ban protest. Who is Wike to ban protest? Who is Wike? Who is Wike? Tell Nigeria, go and ask Wike, who are you to ban protests? No governor. You don't have the right. Even President Muhammadu Buhari, he don't have the right to ban protests. You can't ban protests. That is the only way the common man can express his view. That is the only way the common man can express his anger. That is the only way the common man can express his grievances. Then you want to ban it. You are telling reverse people that they shouldn't come out for protests because the IGP are banned SARS. Who told you? The IGP didn't ban SARS. He swapped, he replaced SARS to swap. I don't want to know the full meaning of swap. We don't need swap. We don't need SARS. It is a simple tax. This will show you that they hate you. This will show you that they don't respect you. Up till now, the IG have refused to come out. He has refused to come out to address the people because it looks that he's too big. The IG is too big. That we are fools, we are animals. That when we come out with a large number, the only thing he can do, he can tell the police, police take us. Shoot aside, maybe they will run. Or kill one. If you kill one, the rest will run away. It's late already. Key two, nobody's going anywhere. Key TV, nobody's. You have been killing. The IGP have been killing Nigerians. The Inspector General of Police have been killing Nigerians. The 36 states that was made up with 36 commissioners have been killing Nigerians. And they think they will continue and we will fold our hands to look like we are fools. This time, we are not fools. We are ready. We told them, we are Nigerians and we are very patriotic and we are very intelligent. We are very, very educated. We are ready. We ask for our rights. We ask to do the needful. It's so simple. Even the people say, this is what they need. That is what you will give to them. You don't go beyond the constitution. You don't go beyond the people. Do you know why? Because the system are totally corrupt. The system has breakdown. It has already corrupt. It's full of corruption. And nobody wants to speak. Because when you speak, they lock you. When you speak, they tear gas you. When you speak, they shoot you. And you say it's a country. We are ready. The protest must continue. We are telling them, we told the IGP, we told President Muhammadu Buhari, we say, end police brutality. You are telling us you are bringing out swap. What kind of fucking swap is that? What makes the difference? These are the same people you will still give gun. They are still the same sacks. They are the same sacks. Now, my question to you, whether you are here, you are a policeman watching me, are you not tired of suffering? Are you not tired of 45,000 per month? Are you not tired of staying in rent? Or are you not tired of roaming the streets with gun for no reason, risking your life to protect the territory of the nation? At the end of the day, you are being paid peanuts. Are you not tired? I'm asking the Nigeria police, if you are a police officer, you are here on my platform, I'm asking you this question. So far, not they tire you? Oh, you think your children cannot go to good school? You think the government cannot fund you? You think the government cannot take care of you? Or you think the government cannot give you funds for you to establish whatever business or for him to make you where they can? The money is there, but they will never do it for you. Let me tell you, if you are a police listening to me, if you are a police officer, you are listening to me, you put the trigger on your innocent citizen, you have cut off your life. You have cut off your generation. If you see people protesting, they are not protesting for themselves. They are protesting for you. They are protesting for your children. They are protesting for your generation. You don't have the right. Think about it. Think about yourself. Think about your salary. Think about you don't have a life insurance. Go to other countries. The police have life insurance. Does the Nigeria police have life insurance? They don't have. They might kill you at any fucking time. They might fire you. Go to the barracks of the Nigeria police force. You will hate. You will spit on them. You will spit on them. It smells. It's so irritating. They can't fund you. They can't fund you. They can't give you a good uniform to wear. They can't take your children to good school. Those people you are guarding, you are using your arms, you are risking your life to guide them. Their children doesn't live here. Their children live in overseas. They are spending your money. Just as they are using us like fools, that is how they are using the Nigerian police force like fools. And you call us fools. You say, you look and you say, bloody civilian. You are the bloody civilian. You are part of the civilian. You are part of the civilian. Whatever we face from this government, you face it too. Whatever we face from the senator, you face it too. And you want to kill your fellow citizen, embrace them. Join the protest. Tell them you cannot be carrying arms for 45,000 per month. Tell them you cannot be carrying arms for 50,000 per month. Tell them your children cannot go to good school. Tell them you are tired of living this kind of frustrated and forsaken life. You deserve a life. As a police officer, you deserve a life. You deserve a life. That is why you must join the protest. Are you not fed up? You are supposed to be fed up. As a police officer, you are supposed to be fed up. Look yourself. Look yourself. Look yourself as a police officer. Sit down. Think. Think about yourself. Think about. How am I cheating doing? How can we stay in just two rooms and I'm carrying arms to protect the life of people? And I'm saving the territory of this country. What are my profits? What will I stand to gain? What will I stand to gain? Think about yourself. Think about your future. Think about your children. Think! Nigeria police, think! Think! Don't think because you are going for operation, you can extort money from the press. You can't live by that. Come to Europe. Police does not extort from anybody, but they are living fine. Their children are living fine. Some even fund their children to America to school. Some fund their children to other countries to school. They have the money. The government take care of them. The government fund them. Ask this government, Nigeria Police Force, ask this government, if this government have fund you, what have you profit from this government, Nigeria Police Force? I'm asking you. I'm asking you, police officer, you are carrying gun to kill your fellow human being. What is your game? What is your game? The government are killing us, you are killing us. You think you are not part of the frustration? You are part of the frustration. You are part of it. You are part of it. See me tomorrow and make arrest to me. I don't even care. Arrest me. You are part of it. Police, you are part of it. You are part of this fraudulent government. You are part of this forsaking good government. You are part of this government who have destroyed us. You are part of it. Are you exempt from it? When your children cannot go to private school? Go and look at the police children. They are roaming in the streets. They are crazy. Some of them are selling pure water. I'm telling them, I'm right. I'm right of what I'm saying. And I owe no apology for this. Police children are suffering badly. Go and look at our Nigeria police force. They will be escorting. They will be escorting one senator. They will be cleaning their shoe. A small boy will come. We take two mobile police and we'll be using them. He will be using them. Who told you they are supposed to use you? Who told you you are supposed to guide a small boy in the streets? You don't have to do. You are bigger than that. As a police officer, you deserve a respect because you send your life to protect the territory of the country. That is why they must respect you. But this government have taken the respect away from you. This government took the respect away from you. That is why when the citizens see you, they look you, as you look them like bloody civilian, they look you too like a bloody goat. Yes, they look you like a bloody goat. If you look us like a bloody civilian, we look you like a bloody goat. I'm talking to not only the Nigerian police, the Nigerian Air Force, the Nigerian Army. You must train the people. Train the people. Because this government is killing you. Go and look at how they are packing your people to Zambeza Forest. When they send them to Zambeza Forest, they will send the terrorists to attack them. We have lost a lot of people. A lot of Nigerian youth have died in the army. That is why I said in my last video, I said, if you are an army officer, you are being sent to Zambeza Forest, I said, put your uniform. Because it's a scam. It's a fake. Fighting Boko Haram is a business. It's a lucrative business. that they have bought at. They are extorting money. They are eating money. Why is the chief of staff not going? Why is Buta, the chief of staff, not going? But when it comes to ordinary citizens trying to protest for their rights, it should be very key to send the army to fire them. Just like the key 80 shot member, those who went to protest for the shite leader that they took, Ezazaki. The key 80. Just imagine, honest people. But you were very quick to fire them. Boom. Yes, that is what they know how to do. They are very proud of it. And you think we are fools? We have woke up. Tell President Muhammadu Buhari that the youth is no longer sleeping. The Nigerian youth, he think that they are so foolish, they are lazy. We have come to tell you, President Muhammadu Buhari, we are not lazy. We will tell you this time, we are vibrant, we are intellectual, we are educated, we are nice, we are patriotic. That is what we show to you. We will show to you this time. This time, it will be for fire, for fire. If they think they are bigger than this country, if they think that they are bigger than Nigeria youth, we are telling them today, you are not bigger than us. Show away to them. He went to see the IG. He went to the IG office. They told him, go back, you can't enter. He said, why can't I enter? He said, come on, come your IG. One of the policemen was calling Show away. He said, you are Ewu. And Show away said, you don't have the right to call me Ewu. You that is suffering. Can't you look at yourself? Are you better than me? He said, I'm better than the president, which is the basic truth. Omoyele Sowore is better than President Muhammadu Buhari. Quote me anywhere.
Thank you very much. Put your comments, what you think about this very video. And don't forget, press the like button. See you in my next video. Thank you very much.